Today, my topic is so-called how language models learn from random start to smart response. Everyone is using ChatGPT these days or generative AI. For example, my students are using ChatGPT and Gemini to write papers for them. Polish papers, not right. And also, if you are traveling, you will use Google Translation. If I travel to France, I don't know how to speak French. I will just use Google Translation to generate, you know, some sentence for me. And also cloud, that is the most powerful one for computer scientists for me because they can write code for me. So everyone is using generative AI these days. But language model, how did they become smart, right? They didn't become smart at the very beginning. I'll give you a very simple example. This example is on ChatGPT volume. You know, they just, you know, people try to compare with two simple numbers, 9.11 versus 9.9. Which one is larger? 9.9 is larger, right? But if you ask ChatGPT last year, last July, they give you the wrong answer. They say that 9.11 is larger than 9.9. Okay. So ChatGPT is definitely powerful, but they cannot even answer this simple question. So it means that they didn't start as a very smart agent or smart model. And how, but they can improve these days. So for example, just a few weeks ago, Google Gemini, you know, they claim that this can solve the IMO problem. And I try that, it's the case. If I add some, you know, give them some hint or some prompt, they can indeed solve IMO problems. Okay, it's very fancy, you know. The, last year, they cannot even tell 9.9, 9.11, which one is larger. But this year, they can solve the IMO problem. And basically, last year, they used the alpha geometry, alpha proof to solve the IMO problem as well. IMO is International Mathematics Olympic, right? For high school students, it may be the most difficult exam. But, you know, ChatGPT can solve them this year. How do they improve from, you know, this kind of nonsense answer, 9.11 is larger than 9.9, to the IMO problem? And today's talk, will, you know, I will, you know, undiscover this kind of magic they use here. Okay, good. So the central question is that how does this language model learn to improve themselves over time? What's the underlying technology they use to improve themselves? Okay, so before I talk about the technology, I'll just give you the underlying idea about the similarity between the human learning and the machine learning. The key principle is learning from mistakes. You know, when you want to become perfect, you know, you cannot become perfect at the very beginning. You have to learn from some experience, and experience is nothing but mistakes. Okay, so the left-hand side figure is a human, right? Is a baby, you know, who want to learn some concept. For example, he's looking at the red ball. You know, he thought it's a kitty. It's definitely not a kitty, right? Because maybe he learned the word kitty before he learned the concept of ball. And his parents is telling him, okay, hello, sweetheart, this is not kitty, this is the red ball. Okay, and he learns these mistakes, and next time he sees the similar ball, you know, he will recognize that's a ball, not a kitty. And similar thing happens in the language model, which is on the right-hand side picture. They use the technique so-called next token prediction. It's something like, okay, when I say a sentence, it's so-called a prompt, and they try to predict the next token based on the previous tokens. For example, the example is like, we have a sentence, the quick brown fox jumps over something. And the right answer is the lazy dog, right? That's the ground truth answer. But the language model at the very beginning, they do not know what's the right answer, they just randomly guess something, a rock, right? And then, because you have the ground truth data, you will tell ChatGPT that's the wrong answer, and they will update their model parameter, you know, to fit this answer. So that is an example of learning from mistakes. Okay? I will give you another example in math, trying to show, you know, how they, you know, try to solve math problems. That's the underlying principle of, you know, why they can solve IMO problem as well. So let's say we have a simple math question. I have one to add from 1 to 10 equal to something. I don't know what's the answer for that. Just keep guessing. Okay, for example, as the computer sees 1 point plus 2, he may not recognize the dot, 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 right? Maybe just the ChatGPT just guess it's 3. And then it's wrong. And he maybe guess it's 13 is wrong as well. And until they find the right answer, 15.5. So the procedure is so-called guess, check, and improve. You know, I just guess something, I check if it's right or not, and then I improve myself automatically. That is learning from mistakes. Okay. And the underlying technology for updating their model or improving their model is so-called model training in terminology in machine learning or artificial intelligence. It's a, you know, closed loop. between the data model and update model. So every time I have a new data, I see some new example, I don't know how what's the answer for that, and I try to guess what's the answer for that. If my answer is wrong, I will get some loss or error. And from that error, I can update my model. I can update my knowledge. And then next time, I will not make the same mistake. And by repeating this loop for many, many times, maybe billions of steps, I can start from a random model to a smart model. So the underlying technology is something so-called learning algorithm. Here's one example, so-called gradient descent. What's the meaning of that? The ball, you can understand the ball as the state of the model. And the height of a mountain means the loss function. When the height is large, the loss is very large. At the very beginning, the loss is extremely large, which means that you don't understand anything. And then it goes downhill until you find the flat region. The flat region has very small loss, which means that you can almost solve all the problems. So that is the underlying learning algorithm people use. So you use billions of the steps of practice to start from a random model and try to improve yourself until a perfect model. Okay. And how does these billions of steps, is taken over time? There are, for language model, there are certain stages. There are three stages. The first stage is like they read all the internet. For example, I just read all the Wikipedia, all the, YouTube video, something like that. I read everything, and then they can learn a base model. And after that, the second step is so-called learning with instructions. They just learn from some refined examples, let's say the textbook or something. They have particular focus on a particular domain, just to solve that problem. Let's say I'm a computer scientist, so I maybe read the book of compilers, programming language, something like that. That's the second step. And the third step is so-called learning from human feedback. So I have a teacher, professional or something like that. They can tell me whether my answer is right or wrong. So through these three steps, they can gradually accumulate knowledge to improve the performance. And also, the last step is so-called scaling up. Because the researchers found that if we scale up the model, we use more compute and more more larger model and more computing resources, the performance is better. So this phenomenon is so-called scaling law, neural scaling laws in machine learning. So the horizontal axis is the compute, and the vertical axis is the error. And you can see that the error actually can decrease when the number of compute units you use. This is something like a predictive scaling law, which means that if I spend more time, spend more money, I will become better. That is the definite fact. It's not something speculative. It's actually definite. We can prove that happens empirically and theoretically. That's called neural scaling laws, which means that you just want to spend more time, more compute to improve yourself. That's why can reduce the error significantly. Okay, and then I have one slide talk about my lab, which is what my lab is doing. My lab is care about efficiency in machine learning. So I can give you some examples. The first example is trying to do the data selection or high quality data curation, something like that. So let's say in the whole internet there are many low quality data and a few high quality data, right? But how can we tell which data is better, which data is bad? So we need a filter algorithm to automatically detect what's going on. So that's one example. The second example is the efficient learning. So for example, as I mentioned in the previous slides, typically you may need billion number of steps. You may need to make billions of mistakes to learn a concept. But my lab is doing some smart algorithm which needs significantly less, let's say just a million number of steps to solve the problem. So that's what my lab is doing, is about efficiency in machine learning in algorithms. So that's my final slide. So I want to tell you that how can machines learn? And if machines can learn, we can also learn. The key secret is that you should never give up. Just learn forever, right? The machine, you use more compute, which means that they make billions of mistakes, more and more mistakes. They can improve. They can improve forever. And if we don't give up, we will keep learning. We will solve every problem. Thank you.